Which twi'lek was the fourth member of Jabba's dancing group in 4AUI? This is one other than Ula.
Oh no.
He doesn't know that much about Star Wars. You got it.
Are we ready to reveal? This is Lyn Me.
Oh!
It feels good to be a gangster.
Yeah, well, what's up, guys? You just got to see my shame. As you know, maybe, I started this channel 4 years ago to study for Dragon Con Star Wars trivia. I still have yet to win, and this year, this guy beat me. This is Zack. He's my good friend, so if I'm going to lose to someone, at least I lost to a friend. But how did you know that answer?
Well, first of all, I just want to say again, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to beat you. It just kind of happened. I wasn't expecting it to happen.
I
still feel bad.
I love in the video the look of shock and then like the single clap and then you stop clapping. You don't know how to react.
Yeah, that was...
Look, we were all surprised.
Including me. Yeah. So anyway, the reason I knew that answer, when I was about 6 or 7 years old, I was out with my dad one night, and he had me wait in the car. When he came back, he surprised me with a 3-pack of Rice Del Grieta and Lyn Me. It was a nice surprise. I guess it stuck with me all these years. I always remembered that, you know, nice little gesture he did for me. So that was why I remembered Lyn Me.
So you have like this Slumdog Millionaire moment.
Mm-hmm.
Where you knew it and I had no idea. Well, since I promised that because I lost on Lyn Me, I would do a video about Lyn Me. Well, since you're the expert on Lyn Me, why don't you just go ahead and explain the character to all of us?
With pleasure. Lyn Me was a twi'lek dancer and backup singer in the Max Rebo band at Jabba's Palace. She grew up on the barren northern continent of Ryloth. Her species suffered generations of hardships, with many twi'leks being sold into slavery by the criminal underworld that exists in their culture. Boba Fett saved the young Lyn Me and many others from slavery before she left the planet. Her village elders pooled their meager resources to pay the famed bounty hunter to exterminate the slavers. As a result, Lyn Me hero-worshipped Fett. She studied twi'lek dance and somehow gained the attention of Max Rebo, who was constantly on the lookout for new talent.
All right, is that it? There can't be any more, right?
Well, if we go over to Star Wars Legends, we learn that the performance we see in the special edition of Return of the Jedi was the first time Lyn Me had seen Boba Fett since she was a child. She was honored to hear that he enjoyed the band's performance, and he promised to meet up with her later. But Boba Fett was presumed killed in the Sarlacc pit, and so Lyn Me swore vengeance on Luke Skywalker and his friends.
Okay, that has to be it. There can't possibly be any more. She's barely in the movie, Zack.
Actually, I have a little behind-the-scenes information, too. In the game Star Wars Demolition, when the player wins as Mal Akili, his victory movie shows Lyn Me fed to Jabba's Mandalore. As Demolition takes place, when Leia frees Han, Lyn Me possibly met this fate before Luke arrives in the palace and Jabba's entourage go to the sail barge. Because this conflicts with the books, saying that Max Rebo band survived the sail barge, led by Lyn Me.
Left its seeds while I was sleeping.
Okay, great, thanks. Now I know everything there possibly is to know about Lyn Me, whose name I will surely never forget again. But I hate her. She's dead to me. I'm kidding. But Zack, thank you for coming over to talk Star Wars with us. Stop apologizing for beating me in trivia. It's okay. You were the better man that day, so congratulations.
Thanks for having me. It was an honor to be here and be on the show.
Oh, I'm glad that you could be a part of it. So if you haven't already, please like this video, subscribe to the channel, follow us on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook, and consider checking out our Patreon page. As always, thanks for watching. And may the Force be with you.